Now, yesterday we talked about putting fools away from us, putting foolishness away from us, and those fools are the evil people. Those fools are the wicked people and the wicked things of this world, and we need to put it away from us. And verse 9 of Proverbs chapter 14 goes ahead and tells us why we need to do that. The Bible says right here in Proverbs chapter 14 and verse 9, says, fools mock at sin. Fools mock at sin. They mock at their own sin. They love their sin. They enjoy their sin. They love the pleasure of their sin, not realizing that it's only for a season and a very short season at that. And so they mock at sin. They mock at other people's sin. They glorify sin. They uplift sin. And they encourage others to follow down the path of sin that they are following in. They call good evil and evil good. And anyone that wants to stand opposed to that sin, they call them wicked. They call them evil, and they will mock at them, and they will they'll try to take them down and destroy them. And so when we look at this, the Bible tells us that fools mock at sin. These are fools. These are foolish people. They don't realize how destructive the nature of that sin is, and that sin is going to ultimately destroy them. But as fools mock at sin and don't recognize the destructive nature of sin, when they see other individuals that have also been caught up in their sin, and that sin is beginning to destroy them, those fools will even mock at them and poke fun at them and use them as a form of their own entertainment. Why? Because their mindset is that of a fool. And as I talked about yesterday, we need to get as far away from those fools. Whether it's through our entertainment systems or our entertainment industry, or the media or whatever it is, we need to get as far away from them as we possibly can. Not allow them to have any influence in our life, because all they are is destructive. They're destroying themselves. They're destroying others, and they want to destroy you as well if you have a heart to stand upon righteousness and purity and morality, true morality, biblical morality, not the evil that they're calling good that they call moral. Yeah, they'll consider themselves to be moral agents and good people, but when they oppose the truth of the Word of God, they're wicked. They're wicked in every single way, shape, and form. It goes on in verse 9, it says, but among the upright there is goodwill. Among the upright there is goodwill. There's goodwill, first of all, towards God. Their heart, the heart of the upright, is to live right with God, to be in goodwill towards God. Being a good favor, in other words, in good standing with God. They want to be honorable. They want to be pleasing unto God. They also want to be honorable to men. Now, whether or not they want to be pleasing unto mankind or not, that's a totally different story, because the only way we're really going to be pleasing unto them is if we partake of their wickedness. And as children of God, we should have absolutely no desire to do that. But just as a fool who, as the Bible says right here, mocks at sin, wants to destroy you, it's not our heart, it's not our intent to destroy you. Rather, it's our heart and our intent to bring you out of that sin, to bring you into a right relationship with Jesus, who can forgive you of that sin and deliver you from that sin. Not to ruin you, not to destroy you, but to be at goodwill, to where you will also be at goodwill, good favor, right standing with God. And the only way we can truly do that is by placing our faith and our trust in the person of Jesus.